All right, Lime Green Nation, it's your boys. We're back for another episode of the Weekly Limelight, recapping last week's tough loss to our nemesis, Green. It was a good game, but we're back here in studio in the luxurious Lime Green Studios. Jeremy's in studio, and Colin, like last week, calling in. And I feel like this week we should do more of a recap because Jeremy wasn't actually there, Colin.
True.
Yeah, so let's see if we can get this little gimmick set up here for you so we can hear you good. So first we lost 20-19.
Yeah, I seen the video.
See, what the video looks good though.
Yeah, it was a good game, Jeremy. You missed a good one. Nice. It was close, competitive. It was pretty good.
Yeah, it was competitive in the latter stages. Early on, it was 2-0 in the top of the first, or bottom first. We didn't do anything in our half. And Tim says, "This has got to be the best defensive inning I've ever been a part of." Like, thanks, Tim.
Well,
yeah, that's the kiss of death right there, when you say something like that.
Yeah.
Well, based off of a little bit of the video I did watch, if you guys play like that and loss, that's a good loss.
Yeah.
But if you play suck and lost, then that's a bad loss, and you can't swallow that. So at least you did take it down to the wire.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty much. So, you're going to have games like this. You're going to have games like this, no matter who you play.
So, second inning, not much happened. I think we got a 1-2-3 on that one. Right in Tim's face, too, because Tim had just said that was the best defensive inning that we had played in. And then the inning after that, we had 1-2-3.
So what kept you guys from getting over the hump? What was it? Was it a mistake made? The reason why they scored? Or I mean, I wasn't there, and I didn't watch the whole video, so I have to ask.
I'll tell you what. We'll get to that. We'll build up to it because it's like a game recap.
Okay.
All right. So this is a new segment on the show. It's called #HumbleAF. I tried it last week, but now it's an official segment.
Greatest hashtag ever.
Thank you. This is the part of the show where I sing my praises. Because
and rightfully so, because that was just incredible.
Well,
and unlikely, and just he had to be there to believe it.
Well, we'll get to the big crescendo at the end there, but let's talk about my heroics in the third inning, because it was 2-0 them. So Tim, selfishly.
Yeah, I like that word.
Took a walk. Because they had a pitcher who wasn't pitching very well at all.
Like, wait a minute. Tim?
Tim walked. Yeah, he drove 5 hours up here to take a walk.
Okay.
He took a couple walks.
Well, he did take a couple walks. You know, we'll get to what else he did, yeah. Too. And so he walked. And with the new rule being that you're already on second base,
yeah.
I was like, all I have to do is just drive this fool in. Right. It is not that hard.
Right.
We just need a run here. Yeah. Make it 2-1.
Right.
And like I said, they had their new pitcher, because they had about four pitchers pitching on Saturday. Was the game Thursday, Friday, Saturday, whatever it was.
Yeah.
And
I think it was Friday.
Saturday.
Yeah.
So their pitcher was pitching exactly like the batting cage at BWI.
Is that right?
The ball was way over your head.
They allow that?
Well, no, he wasn't doing it all. I mean, he was trying to get strikes.
But they allow that.
No, but it was a ball. It would still be a ball.
That's true. But usually the blue would tell him bring the ball down.
Well, right. But that's why Tim walked.
Okay. Okay, I got you.
So I saw this is not a perfect opportunity. I've been working on my hack skills at the batting cage because that's all you can do there.
Yeah.
I was like, all I'll do is just drive this fool in.
Yeah.
And just tomahawk chop that bad boy.
Yeah.
And I'm watching the ball, and I'm like, there's no way how they're going to catch this. But Tim is so fundamentally sound that he has to wait for the ball to drop to take off from second base. The thing is, too, is that Tim isn't as young as he used to be. He's a little slower.
A little slow.
And I'm like, this fool's going to get tagged out at home. He should have scored 10 minutes ago.
All right.
But he's taking forever around these bases. But
he also had a lot of crabs and stuff, too.
Yeah.
Before the game, I heard. That was a big factor as well.
Yeah,
advisable to do before a game.
He had some crabs. I think he had a couple of
Steinweisers.
Yeah, some adult beverages before the game.
Hot beverages.
So he scores. I'm on first base. And who knew that my heroics would lead to a 11 run bottom of the third inning. 11 runs, a couple walks here and there. So yeah, you get the guy at second base. I know Adam hit the ball really far.
What field you guys was on?
Six.
Okay.
Yeah. Allison had a nice hit to drive in some runs. So everyone was putting the bat on the ball in that inning. Mm-hmm. People were scoring. And then the last of the runs, so Sarah hits the ball. She gets a little single here. And I'm not picking on her. This is just what happened. So she runs over to first base and makes the turn to second base. And I'm not sure why she didn't get back to first base immediately, but she didn't. And they chose to focus on her getting that out over there instead of watching two people sneak around third base and score. So we got two more runs right there.
Yeah.
So like in actuality, her turning like that got us two more runs.
Yeah.
But that also cleared the bases.
Even though she didn't mean to do that.
Yeah. And then Tim got up. And what happened, Colin? Tell the people at home what Tim did.
That was what Tim did?
Yeah. He hit a ball so far, I don't think it's landed yet.
Is that right?
Actually, I just informed that I get to go home early.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're closing our building down.
Well, hey, that's what happens on live radio here. Yeah, or not radio, but
about that. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, then Kyle, go.
Hopefully, if you guys go on for a while, hopefully I can jump back on. If not, that actually kind of sucks because I enjoy this program.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, we'll get back to you on the next one then, I guess, Colin.
Yeah.
Or I mean,
brief but short.
Yeah, like, you don't have a Bluetooth headset that calls when you're driving.
I do not. All right. Unfortunately.
No problem.
Well, you know, don't we have a game?
We have a game Friday.
Friday. So this will be a double podcast.
Well, this week, yeah, we'll get two for the price of one here.
That's right, pretty much.
I mean, unless we go get some eats after the game. I was trying to get this thing going with the restaurant, but you see, I'm having problems with the machine. So, yeah. All right, Colin,
Colin.
Handle your business, and I'll fill in here with Jeremy.
We'll see you game day.
Yep.
All right, bud.
See ya.
I do.
All right, hang up on that. Okay, so like I said, Tim hit a ball that
on field six.
On field six, that I don't think has landed yet. But
what do you mean you didn't feel it landed yet? I mean, he hit the ball out of the.
To be fair, he did not hit it out of the park, but he hit it so far that they're just like, oh my god, like, why even run after it? And you know, Tim's pretty slow. Like, there's no point in that video because the camera was set up at our dugout.
I saw that.
That you see them throwing the ball in, so it was that's how far it was. That they were still getting it when Tim was rounding the bases.
Yeah,
so he definitely got a hold of one there.
What was it? He triple?
That was a home run.
Is that right?
That was his home run, as opposed to mine, which we'll get to in a little bit.
So in other words, he hit the ball. He got an in the park home run, but he hit it in an alley, or he hit it somewhere so far.
He hit it down the line. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So far, the girl was like,
screw. So that relay was just, that relay just sucked. So he just.
Well, there was no relay. They were still getting the ball. Okay. That's what I'm saying. Like, he may have one hopped that fence.
Yeah. Okay.
It was savage. So pretty good hit. Yeah. You know, we'll give him all the credit in the world. I know he loves to hear it. He probably listens to this garbage of a show.
Yeah.
So Tim, quality hit. So then, we're up 11-2.
Yeah, Tim, which actually means nothing because we still lost.
We still lost. Yeah, home run was for nothing.
Yeah, yeah.
So we're up 11-2, and then we have a good. I come in to pitch because he's tired from running the bases twice, and he's pretty old. He's like, can you pitch? I'm like, yeah, sure. I'll pitch. I didn't do too much of that inning.
Yeah.
And I came in, and again, hashtag humble AF. I pitched a scoreless inning of relief.
That's impressive.
Oh God, it was beautiful. I was nailing that thing, man. They had no answer for my pitching.
Brought back old times, huh?
God, man, that was glorious.
Yeah,
if I had my little other music thing going.
Well, considering that pitching on our team, our pitcher was absent, like I was absent, which is Bobby. So he would appreciate it knowing that you did that for him. Now I want to get to the shortstop part, but we'll get to that once you get finished the story.
I got to recap
shortstop.
The game.
Yeah, okay.
All right. So then we attack on two more runs.
Okay.
Make it 13-2.
Mm-hmm.
And Kathy, you're not listening to this. I know you're not listening to it. I kept score the entire game. I even had someone take a little picture of me keeping the score, like, so I could show
it. I saw that. Yeah.
So, all right, 13-2. And then I was more than happy at that point to just give him a couple runs here and there. As long as we got gave him a couple runs, it got out of the inning. Uh-huh. We were hitting, so it's not like we were going to add more runs ourselves. Uh-huh. And we'll fast forward here to the...
So we were up...
17 to... Gosh, I want to say maybe... 17-10.
Okay, up 7-1.
And this now this is bottom six.
Okay.
So we tackle on a few more runs, and we're up 17-6. Mm-hmm. Or, excuse me, 17-10. Mm-hmm. And we get an out. And then another out. The second out is important because it's a funny play. There's a girl that hit just a little pop-up to me. Mm-hmm. It was a floater. It was never in doubt. I was pitching. Mm-hmm. That I was going to catch the ball. Mm-hmm. I put my arms out, but I didn't say, I got it. Who's going to run into me?
Right.
But Tim's on the sideline, and he's giving me a hard time. He's like, you're supposed to call that. I'm like, come on. It's pretty blatantly obvious that I'm catching it.
Right.
But there's a reason why you're supposed to call it very loudly.
Yeah.
The very next play, there is a ball hit to the outfield. Brent is playing shortstop. Takes a charge, so he's going backwards. Janet's coming in a little bit. Janet didn't have to move left or right, so it was directly her line of vision.
Yeah.
It's right in front of her, so she's got her head up to catch the ball. Brent
is backing up.
He's left-handed, so he's going like this. I mean, you can't think of it. I'm left-handed, so I can do that.
Right.
There's no way that
either one of them knew that what was going to happen, unless someone say split or somebody called it.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, Janet, to her credit, has told me that she's called it. I was pitching, so
Before you go on,
yeah,
was it a shortstop hard catch or outfield easy catch?
It was kind of like no man's land, but it was much easier for Janet to catch it. Like Janet actually put her glove on the ball.
Okay, so nobody actually called it.
She called it.
Yeah. Oh, but Brent didn't listen.
Brent maybe didn't hear her.
Okay.
Maybe her voice didn't carry far enough, and he wasn't looking.
Yeah.
And, you know, Brent is at least two times bigger than she is, two and a half times bigger. He's a thick guy.
Yeah.
Just demolished her.
Really?
So, yeah. So, you know, they score a couple of runs there, and we have to, you know, freeze the game.
Yeah.
And Janet, she goes right back to her broken arm.
Yeah.
And you can just see the look on her face, and she says, nobody touch me. Because I ran over there, and like the bodyguard, I'm trying to run slow motion.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I'm going to like pick her up and carry her off the field because my friend is hurt.
Yeah.
She's like, nobody touch me. And you know how tough she is?
Yeah.
She took herself out of the game.
Wow.
Yeah. You should see his face. Jeremy is very shocked right now because Janet does not just take herself out of the game. But I think that she was she was in shock. That happened, and if you, I had it on my phone in slow motion. There's like a whiplash effect of her neck hitting the ground. Mm-hmm. So I know she probably had a big headache too, and her body hurt and everything. A lot of soreness going on there. Took herself out of, so we had to rearrange some stuff. Mm-hmm. So like Tim, who was on the bench because he was the extra guy at that point, he came in to catch. We had to put Sarah and Amanda over here, like at first base, second base, or whatever. Just kind of rearranged some stuff. Had to move. I believe Rachel took over from second to left field just for the inning. Mm-hmm. And just because now we had people playing stuff that they weren't playing before, mm-hmm. you know, just get some hits here and there. And some mistakes happen. And they next thing you know, it's 17-17. Now, here's the best part. I don't know who listens to this.
That was a kill joint. Now, that injury kind of knocked the life out.
Right. Now everyone's kind of concerned for Janet, but also, like I said, people are not used to playing where they were playing.
Yeah.
But here's, like I said, here's a behind-the-scenes secret. If anybody listens to this, I don't know. Who cares? It didn't really matter in the long run. So Brent's parents were there. Lovely people. Mm-hmm. Fantastic. I wish that they would come to every game. They were such great people. Mm-hmm. I even flat out asked Brent if he was adopted. Mm-hmm. So
imagine that.
Yeah. So so I was keeping score, like I said, Kathy, I was keeping score. And to me, later on when they came back to tie the game, what we called a tie, I thought they scored 18 runs and we only had 17. So I thought they were up one. Mm-hmm. And I had my little notepad out there and I put the notepad down because the umpire said, tie ball game. So I was like, I'm going to hide my little notepad over here and hope that they don't come ask me mm-hmm. what I have for a score.
Who was blue that game?
This guy, Rick, he was an umpire at the last game that we okay. So and he'll be umpiring our game on Friday.
Yeah.
So when he said tie ball game, I'm like, yep, okay. But of course, here comes Tim, and Tim's kind of giving me crap. He's like, no, Kevin, I know for a fact we have 18. I'm like, Tim, shut up. He's like, no, I know we have 18. We don't. We have 17. They have 18. They call tie game. They're keeping score over there. Tie game. Oh, okay. In that case, yeah. He's like, oh, okay. Yeah. So I was like, yeah, hell yeah, it's a tie ball game. No problem.
Yeah.
So. Same situation as the bottom of the third inning, Tim led off. He led off with a walk. Again, Tim does not want to walk.
Right.
He took a walk. So I know he's on second base. And we kind of got the groove back a little bit defensively. It's like, if we could just tack on one run here, mm-hmm. we can just hold him mm-hmm. and we'll win the game. No big deal.
Right.
So I forgot who was ahead of me, the girl, and then they got out. I came up the bat. And my two previous at bats before that, mm-hmm. I was trying to find a hole in center field, but they had a good outfielder that was catching really well.
Yeah,
and just didn't work out for myself. Mm-hmm. I'm going to hit that down the right field line. That way, I know Tim will score. And I hit a laser down that line. It just right against the chalk, and the girl misplayed it. Mm-hmm. So I saw her misplay it. I'm like, well, I'll get two. I turned around to see where the ball was, and the ball was still in the outfield.
Yeah.
So I'm taking three, but in my mind, I knew we already had the one run, so I knew we were good there.
Yeah.
In my mind, I'm thinking, my ass is so huge that hopefully the third baseman can no longer see where the ball is
because
I'm so wide that maybe he'll just lose it. And I was kind of half right. The ball was coming in, but the throw hit my leg, and it just slightly deflected off to the side. So he was over here, and the ball went this way, and it went past him. So I was like, shit, I'm scoring.
Yeah.
I don't even care anymore. And I turned around, and if you watch the video, you can literally see where I lost about 50% of the little bit of speed I had left.
Yeah.
I'm coming around third, I'm going a little bit, and then I'm halfway down. It looks like it's a slow motion, but it's real time, people. It's real time. Yeah. I am that slow.
Yeah.
And I slide, and I just die right there in the mud, but my tippy toe hit the plate. Now, what I didn't realize until I saw the video later on was they made a throw that if the guy would have caught it, I definitely would have been out.
Yeah.
But I'm safe. We're up two.
Yeah.
Good. That's all we need.
Yeah.
And then they came up and just bad luck. I don't want to get into it right now, but just a couple little mistakes here and there. And
a couple of little defense mistakes.
Defensive mistakes.
Was those people with the defense mistakes were in positions they not used to?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. So, and then
that breaks the comfortability.
Right. So that's what happened, and of course they're just score the run that they need to tie the game, win the game, and that's it. Mm-hmm. So that was the recap of the game.
Mm-hmm.
2019 loss, tough, but it's good. It was a really good game. I mean, I was on an emotional high after the game. I was like, this is a really good game. So sometimes you just want to be involved in a really good game. So, the first week sucked. We got blown out real bad.
Yeah.
So at least this was fun and competitive. Well, we lost, the team that we're playing on Friday. I don't know how it got to that point, but I saw that they lost 19-18. Hmm. So they probably just came out of a good game like that too.
Probably like 0-3.
We are 0-3. I mean, the losses don't matter, and the wins don't, because you're already in the tournament. So to me, it's just like a tune, like a 3-month tune-up. To get ready for the...
It's like a on-season practice.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's the thing, if we had had some practice, so people... Because, you're not entirely sure what you're getting with everybody quite yet, because you're just kind of throwing them into the fire.
Right.
We have this new girl, Rachel, who I had to play second base. I don't know if she can play second base, but she looks like she can play.
Yeah.
She was there. She took care of business.
She handled it?
Yeah, she handled it. Oh. She got some hits. So, I might actually have to ask her to play first base this week because Amanda's not going to be there. So we'll see how that goes, you know. And that's the thing, she's brand new, haven't had a single practice or really even a chance to really talk to her to see,
yeah,
feel her out, yeah, and see what's what. So
how's Janet doing?
So yeah, I talked to her immediately, and you know, she's tough because, you know, she's Janet.
Yeah, she's
hood tough,
and she knows me, and her favorite slogan to me is
what? Oh, unbreakable.
And
what?
Don't what?
Oh, black don't crack.
There you go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, she's hood tough.
Okay,
so
there you go.
She's got a pounding headache. She actually went and saw a doctor yesterday.
Is that right?
Yeah, so I'm glad I'm recording this today and not on Sunday when I originally recorded this.
She's getting slightly migraines or something like that.
Yeah, well, if that continues, she'll definitely need to see, I guess, a neurologist or something.
Yeah.
But, she, you know, they told her just a little physical therapy, so she has some stretches that she can do or whatever. And I know she listens to this now. She listened to the last one that was 51 minutes while she was cleaning her house.
Yeah.
That's why I'm talking about her so much, because I know she listens.
Yeah.
Her only problem is, and I don't know if Brent listens to this or not, is when you know how Brent is. He's a competitor. He's very competitive.
Well, that was a probably, because who called it, and the person called it, the opposite person should have backed off. But that was one of those situations where they both wanted to make an out.
Yeah. There's nothing about that. That's fine.
And pros go through that.
Yeah. Oh, pros.
The call is made, and right, just, I mean, it's no different than you and I.
Right.
We try to put the game on our shoulders. We talked about that last time.
Right.
We try to put the game on our shoulders, and sometimes these situations happen. They're called the unfortunate situation. Right. So
no. So what I'm getting at is that she was pretty upset after the game.
Yeah.
Because she just felt like Brent didn't
respect her call.
No, not even that. Just like make sure she was okay.
Oh, after the fact.
Yeah.
Okay.
But he did text me later on. He texted me to, you know, to see how she was doing. But I think she just wanted something like at the time, and you know,
when it actually happened, to be there.
Yeah. So I mean, but that's not gonna bring the whole team down. It's just.
And then I mean, sometimes you got to look at. Let's look at. If Brent's listening and Janet listen, you look at Brent's defense. His defense is he knows Janet is strong.
Yeah.
So maybe he didn't look at it as you felt bad.
Right.
You know, we know that you know, two people collide together, and you know that he's a lot thicker than she is.
Yeah.
So she'll bounce around, but he's watched her go through what, two surgeries?
Yeah.
So, you know, his perspective was, you know, we just you know, we bumped and, you know, she fell down and bruised herself, but she's tough. She don't want me to come over and ask if she's okay because she's tough, you know, and a lot of people like that. If I'm getting hit or whatever case me, I really don't want you to touch me either. I don't want you to say, am I okay? Because I'm tough.
Right.
You see what I mean? Your mind is already, Collins uses a perfect example. He says, we are in game mindset.
Yeah.
Game mindset, no matter what takes place, that's where we're at.
Yeah.
So if you came over and asked me, man, you okay? I'll probably look at you weird. Because that's where our mind is at. Now, after the game, I'll probably say, Kevin, did you say anything to me?
Mm-hmm.
So, to Brent's defense, maybe that's what he did.
I completely get that.
Yeah.
Those two have a really weird
They do.
Dynamic.
They do. Because she's seen the pitch. She's seen the hit first, and Brent seems to come up second. And she always say when she's on first base, she has to duck.
No, and I'm not saying that Brent doesn't care. I'm sure Brent genuinely cares
about her.
Well,
that's not even a question.
Right.
That's not even a
question. It's just that...
the emotionals was very
he just didn't realize maybe how bad she was hurt, and she was looking for something, he didn't realize it,
and usually on a collision like that, one person gets the worst of it.
So I mean, like I said, that we'll get back from that, you know. She'll be okay by Friday.
No, she will, because she came back from two surgeries. Nobody comes back from two surgeries and still play.
Yes.
Unless they're black and they don't cry.
Janet, you're double tough. And again, I know you listen to this, so I said that's what I'm talking about you. And we hope that you're doing better.
Yeah.
So, okay, so Brent played shortstop, as I mentioned earlier. And Brent has this unusual
wind up.
Yes.
Brent, if you know I'm going there, your wind up takes forever. It's only 60 feet, you know that, down from home plate to first base. By the time you wind, they are already there. So, that's just a funny thing. I mean, you're left-handed, and that's your way of doing things, but you're an outfielder.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it is what it is.
Matt and Adam played in the outfield. And now, I mean, I feel bad for Matt. Cause, you know,
that's an interesting couple out there.
Well, you know how hard sometimes Matt takes things. I told him after the game.
Very emotional guy.
Yeah, like, you know, that field is so hard to judge.
It's you have a lot going on out in field six.
Yeah.
It's tough.
Yeah, it's very tough. I mean, it's tough on the infield, too. Like, you know, you play back sometimes. And then,
well, that's come to their defense. We did this the last game.
Yeah.
If you look at how the grass is cut, that line supposed to be up further. But when you play up, it's almost like the girls or the guys, they almost like time it, because if you play, you're really not playing up where legally you're supposed to play, because the grass line.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like field one.
Right.
Field one, you know where the grass line is. Mm-hmm. Field six, you don't know. So you almost getting, the infield is huge.
Yeah.
Because there's no grass line.
Yeah.
So for the guys in the outfield, I mean, y'all covering an awful, on field six, y'all covering an awful lot.
Yeah.
And playing together, that may work, but you're going to get some, they're going to find a hole. I mean, that's just the unfortunate, that's the whole chess game of playing softball.
Both teams can hit. I mean, so with the same way we found the hole and got some base hits.
That's right.
They can do it too.
That's right. That's right. Well, it wouldn't be a game if you didn't do that. That's the whole point of the chess game, is to break your opponent down and find the weaknesses and stick to it.
Yeah, this is what sticks is that we were up by so many. So we just couldn't hold them all the way through, you know. Yeah. If maybe you were playing shortstop the way you know, if the normal people were in the right positions.
But still,
we're going to take a break here for a second.
We'll be back.
We'll be right back. All right, we're back. Sorry about that. That's what happens when you're recording at the luxurious palatial Lime Green Studios. But we're talking about people in different positions. So we had Brent and shortstop. We had Banky and Adam play like, okay, actually I messed up. See, that's where I made a mistake, because so you weren't there and Bobby wasn't there. No shortstop, no pitcher.
Yeah.
And we had Tim as a special guest, superstar that he is, show up, and you know, I was right away, I'm like, oh, Tim should pitch. I know Tim, he's a good pitcher, he likes to pitch. He was happy to be there. He just wanted to do whatever.
Yeah.
What I really should have done was I should have had Adam pitch, because Adam is our backup pitcher. I should have had Brent stay in the outfield, and then maybe Tim play shortstop.
Exactly.
And I just do whatever I feel, you know, if I want to, whatever. That should have been ideal for the people that I had.
Yeah.
I messed up. I let Brent play shortstop or whatever. And not that Brent was terrible, but, you know, it is tough for left-handed people to play shortstop. Mm-hmm. So that would have been a better use of the people that I had.
Yeah. Because you only had really two positions that you really majorly had to cover. Yeah. Two challenging positions you really had to cover, which was pitching and shortstop.
Yeah, because pitching ain't easy.
That's right. Yeah, shortstop definitely ain't.
You don't do much defensively, but to get the ball across that plate, all, you know.
Yeah. Well, actually you do, because you control all the infield.
Right. Well, and that's why I had a lot of faith in Tim to pitch, because I knew Tim does it. You know, he's done it for me before, so I was like, no, he's sure Tim can pitch. Yeah. But really, I should have had Adam pitch, because Adam is our backup pitcher. Mm-hmm. But then again, I did come in and pitch relief inning scoreless.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah,
wasn't all bad pitching. Wink, wink.
Yeah.
So tell us about your weekend, Jeremy.
Say it again.
Tell us about your weekend.
Oh, Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh. It's really nothing to tell, because I try to stay awake as far away from Heinz Field as possible.
Yeah.
And as far away from NNP or whatever, Pittsburgh Pirates Stadium.
PNC Park.
Yeah. And you know, the whole time, excuse my language again, but I had penguins hanging out my ass the whole time I was up there. Two times.
Back to back. Oh, hang on.
Break time.
Hello. All right. Sorry about that. Again, so you were in Pittsburgh. Penguins at the Wazoo, because they just won the last two Stanley Cup championships.
Yeah.
Yep.
Look, know this about me right now, people. The Pittsburgh Penguins, to me, are the New York Yankees of this area. People hate the Yankees because of the Orioles. I hate the Pittsburgh Penguins. I hate the animal penguins because of the Pittsburgh Penguins. I won't even let my kids buy stuffed animal penguins. Penguins are the goddamn devil to me.
Oh, it was fun. It was, the trip was fun.
Well, as long as the trip was fun, you had to endure that.
But I wish... I wish I was playing.
Oh, there it is. Everyone came up to me. I said, where's Jeremy? Jeremy never misses a game.
No, I don't miss a game.
And I said, oh, you know, he's on vacation with his new girlfriend. Really?
Yeah.
Not that you were on vacation or that you had a new girlfriend, just that you were missing a game.
Yeah. I don't miss days from work.
Yeah. So, I mean, you got to be someone special to take you away for a softball game.
Yeah, yeah. Takes a special person to do that.
Yeah. Because, you know, I mentioned a few times during the week that my kids were away. My kids were camping, and Amy went and joined them earlier Saturday. Did I miss the hell out of them? Yes. But they're like, do you want to come?
No.
I got a game later on today.
Yeah.
But you barely play. Yeah, but I'm in charge, and I got to be there and stuff. So,
110%. Friday we play.
We play there. Friday. We play Friday on field six.
We're back on field six. We spend a lot of time on field six.
Yeah, but then you get a couple games on field one in a row. Somehow it evens up. But right now the weather forecast is not looking the best.
One of my greatest games were on field six.
I haven't had to worry about the weather for 3 weeks now. But right now it just says different outlets are reporting, like someone's saying that it's going to rain off and on the rest of the week,
mm-hmm.
and some others are saying there's chances of a thunderstorm Friday, but which to me is okay because they always get pushed back later in the day. What do you have? 80% chance of scattered thunderstorms.
So let's look at later. Time limits.
3, 5, 5. Clear by 7, but those,
it depends.
Yeah, those can always get pushed back.
So you're talking like northeast as well. Well, it's up in the air.
Yeah.
But if you're talking 80%, we're going to get something. Just don't know where it's going to be.
Yeah, and on field six, if it drizzles for 10 seconds,
you might as well forget it.
It's ruined.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, to me, I'm planning on being there Friday night. Planning on...
I'll be in rare form.
Yeah, he'll be in rare form. We should have everybody except for Amanda. And, man, we look good in our new uniforms.
I was checking out the pictures. Y'all played like y'all looked.
Actually, yes. Yeah, so someone said, "Oh, it's got to be the new uniforms because we were playing real well."
Played like y'all look. Yeah.
Just,
that was a good song.
Just couldn't hold it. So. White gold. Sorry about that.
Just thinking about having the championship trophy. Think about having the championship trophy white gold. Have you heard white gold?
Oh, yeah. That's the thing. I'm making our, not just the trophy, but our rings. I'm already making them now. If you don't know.
You know that's not a bad idea.
I'm a jeweler by trade. You know, my family owns a jewelry store. Oh, actually, I'm not even a real jeweler. I don't do anything. But.
Can you do that?
I could make something if I want to. I just don't because we have someone here to.
You mean, okay.
To do it for us. Right,
so, could we do that?
What, make some rings if we win something?
No, I didn't say that.
Oh.
I said nothing about winning something. because you have the honor to be on this team.
Yeah.
You really don't have to win a championship to actually wear a ring to represent who you play for.
Okay, I'll tell you this.
So it's called a team ring. A team ring.
Like we're gonna get engaged together? Like
well, we are a team.
We are a team.
And a team is a what? It's a family.
That's what I want.
A family is what? A relationship.
Yeah.
So if you want to say we engage.
This is the 14th season. So at the end of season 10, so a couple years ago, I was trying to think of a gift for everybody. Because actually, like the 10th season was kind of like the end of one era,
mm-hmm.
and the beginning of a new one. Because mm-hmm. normally, like Becky was still playing, mm-hmm. but then she got hurt and everything, and so she kind of stopped and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And we lost AJ because AJ went and joined. So it was really like the end of the original era and the beginning of a new one. and like my cousin Joshua and stuff too. Mm-hmm. So I was trying to think of like a gift, and I came back here to work one day, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna order everyone their digit, like their number. We can, you know, make the numbers, and so that wasn't even good enough for me anymore. Then I was like, you know, I should find like green diamonds, because they're not as expensive as you think they are.
Yeah.
And I'll make the numbers with green diamonds in mm-hmm. in the numbers. Mm-hmm. And now I'm running bills of like, I don't know, $150 to $200 a person. And I'm like, it's probably too much. Maybe I'll use the lime green stone. And even then it was still like $50 a person. Mm-hmm. So I just never got to it. The company that we order from stopped manufacturing the numbers.
Well, I mean, I would say rings for whoever wants to purchase.
LG.
I mean, our merchandise should be where you can go get it if you want it anyway.
Yeah.
I mean, think about it. Everybody's not going to purchase hats. Everybody's not going to purchase wristbands or whatever it could be. Colin went out and did his own thing and bought some stuff online. So, okay, if it's there available, why not just have it there available? If I want to buy a ring that has lime green on it, why not buy a green? It's no different than the class ring.
Oh, hang on.
I found
it. Oh, okay.
All
right. Well, all right, you know what? Maybe we should just finish it up here. We've been rambling on now for 36 minutes. I think that's pretty good.
Pretty good for today.
Especially if we have another game coming up, we can do a whole nother podcast.
Double podcast.
Double podcast this week, double coming at you. Plus, I got to even see if this one will work out since it's a new thing. So for...
That is not the exit music, but it sounds good.
Yeah. So for Kevin, for Super, and for Colin, this is us checking out of the limelight. Thanks, guys.
Okay.